Welcome to the Spirit of Life channel. This message begin right now. Connecting with your Council of Light beloved Masters, are you ready to take the next leap in evolutionary consciousness as you strive to reintegrate the multiple facets of your Divine Self? Are you willing to release those thought patterns, possessions, and relationships that no longer serve the greatest good? As a participant in the grand drama of life you are in the midst of, you have assumed many roles and played many parts. It is our greatest desire to assist you in clearing away the distorted illusions of life, as you learn to focus on what is permanent and lasting, and that which is vital to your overall well-being. Let us review a few of the many roles you have played over the years, and especially those you are presently caught up in. The role of a child/parent, a child is innocent, filled with wonder, and excited by all the myriad possibilities the world and life has to offer. A child is like an empty vessel just waiting to be filled with knowledge, skills, and awareness of the laws and workings of the world. A child is also vulnerable and looks for guidance and safe boundaries from those around them who seem to be wiser and stronger. It takes time for a child to learn right from wrong and the rules of cause and effect. A child is dependent on those around them to set a good example, and to firmly but lovingly guide them on the path toward self-sufficiency. Many of the truths that are forced upon a child haunt them throughout their lifetime and even beyond if they cannot release or transform them into higher and more empowering truths. Your parents played a specific role in your life, presenting to you those things you most need to be aware of, overcome, strengthen, or need to forgive and release. Your lessons and experiences have been are being presented to you in both positive and negative ways, depending on the energies each of you carry and present to each other. Have you integrated the best your parents have had to offer, or are you perpetuating the negative examples they have presented to you? You may have to search deep within, but we assure you, your parents and your children have gifted or are gifting you with many gems of wisdom, love, and inspiration if you seek deeply enough. Each of you willingly assumed a role, positive or negative, so that you all may evolve and grow in wisdom and strength and awareness. Assume the viewpoint of a child, if you will, and attempt to rise above the everyday interactions and drama of your roles with both your parents and, if you have them, with your own children as you view them from our vantage point. Be honest in your assessment, for it will serve to enlighten you as to the steps you need to take in order to attain self-mastery and empowerment. Do you take responsibility for your actions or do you become angry, make excuses, or deny your mistakes and shortcomings? Do you endeavor to fulfill your duties and obligations in a timely and appropriate manner with a joyful attitude? Do you resent your responsibilities and see them as a burden instead of an opportunity to support and serve those around you? Do you express your appreciation to those who serve you in return? Do you still believe that in order for you to be right, someone else must be wrong? How often do you fall into the role of childish, irresponsible behavior? Are you still acting or interacting in some old conditioned childish ways? Are you willing to let go of the painful experiences of the past, and assume the strengths and wisdom your parents have portrayed to you? Are you willing to allow your children to follow their own path, to be different, and not become that which you wish them to be? Each soul is unique and must be given an opportunity to express themselves in their own individualized way. It is your role to nurture, guide and direct, to give counsel, and to protect them as they slowly step into each new phase of life. Through good example and gentle guidance, and by gradually relinquishing control, you will assist your children to fulfill their potential and become aware, responsible adults. You must also allow them to make mistakes and experience the consequences of their actions. If you were not given that loving support, think of how much sooner you would have become an aware adult if you had, and how much easier your life would have been. It is a gift beyond compare. Have you learned to set boundaries, clearly state the guidelines in which you intend to operate and what you expect from those around you? All must know the rules of the game of life, and the rewards and the consequences must be clearly spelled out. Each member should understand their responsibilities and the duties they are to perform for the welfare of all, and the benefits and restrictions should be clearly outlined as well. Asterisk, have you ever considered having a family board meeting whereby each member can state their concerns, seek guidance, make objective suggestions and also help in making decisions that affect the family group? Responsibility is learned one small action and thought at a time. Adulthood does not automatically instill responsibility and compassionate action. It is appropriate and desired to be light of heart, and carefree in spirit. However, it is important that each person learn at an early age that they are an integral part of a vaster whole. They should be made aware that they will be bestowed with many gifts and benefits from those around them, however, they must also make a contribution, however small, as well as learn to be responsible for their actions. The rules of cause and effect, giving and receiving, and the laws of manifestation are universal and should be taught at an early age. How much easier the childhood years would be if this were so. The role of siblings, relatives, friends, and partners, most often, those closest to you are soul companions who have agreed to play a specific role in your drama of life. You must remember that your drama is unique to you, therefore, you have a filter through which you view life and the different people in your life, and you also have some preconditioned emotional patterns from previous interactions with them, or with others who they agreed to stand in for. Oftentimes they agreed to play a composite role, displaying various negative attributes and challenges and/or support and inspiration, depending on the role they assumed. Also, you will usually play roles of polarity for each other, or opposite roles, so that you will have an opportunity to see what you have projected out into the world in the past. Asterisk, examine your relationships with others. Are you growing and evolving together or are you stagnating, caught up in inertia as you replay the same old tapes over and over? Asterisk, are you holding back from stepping into your power because you do not want to create discomfort or stress in your relationships? Are you afraid to set boundaries and state your intention, even if it is in opposition or different from those around you? Are you afraid of what people will think if you start to demonstrate and live your new beliefs and empowerment? Asterisk, are there people in your life who challenge you and ask, what is the matter with you? You have changed. Why aren't you like you used to be? Asterisk, are you hanging on to old relationships because you are afraid of hurting someone's feelings? Do you feel as if you are alone even amongst a crowd? Do you find it difficult to make small talk? Asterisk, are you brave enough to release those in your life with whom you no longer have anything beneficial to share? Can you bless them and love them for their uniqueness and the spark of the divine within them, as you realize that your journey together is over and it is time to follow your own path and to allow them to follow theirs? Your soul family is much vaster than you can ever realize. It is important for you to understand that those with whom you are interacting during this lifetime are playing only a small part in your greater drama of life. Do not misunderstand. Many of those in your life are part of your immediate soul family and you have been with them in many lifetimes before and will be again. But there are also those who you might say are only passing through and did not intend to stay with you forever. Your cosmic drama is much more complex than you are aware of, and so do not place human conditions and limitation on your spiritual journey throughout the cosmos. As we have told you before, it may have taken many lifetimes to reap the rewards or the negative karmic interactions of a past lifetime, but that is no longer the case. As the process of transformation and ascension accelerates, so does the co-creative process. That which you project, both positive or negative, will return to you at an ever-accelerated pace so that it may seem almost instantaneous. Those of you who have returned to center and are maintaining a positive flow of energy have begun to see the results of your endeavors via the many miracles and positive events in your lives. However, those who are projecting negative vibrations of hate, fear, lack, and a desire to control, are feeling the painful results of their actions in multiple ways and within a very short time. At every level, that which has been hidden for a very long time is now being revealed. That which is not in balance and in harmony with universal laws is slowly crumbling in order to be reconstructed on firm ground, to be rebuilt with integrity and in accordance with the divine plan. You have heard and read about the many different councils in the higher realms, but are you aware that before you left the great central sun of this universe you were assigned to a council of wise beings who represented the 12 rays of divine consciousness who exemplify the many attributes, qualities, and virtues of our Father/Mother God? In between incarnations, it is this council of 12 that you confer with and receive guidance from in order to decide what persona, disguise, you will assume in your next life, your parents, the DNA, bodily form, attributes and limitations, mental abilities, talents, strengths and weaknesses, you will incorporate, as well as the conditions in which you will be born, and the challenges and opportunities you will be presented with. Accept this truth. No matter what limitations, conditions, or restrictions you came into this lifetime with, it was never meant to be a punishment. It was always your agreed choice, and an opportunity for you to clear/rectify some distorted karmic overlays within your auric field as you strive to return to the balance and harmony of the middle path. It is our desire to instill in your consciousness that you can and do consult with your Council of Light whether you are aware of it or not. As the veils of illusion between the multi-dimensions slowly fade away, they are being replaced by light filaments containing the knowledge you are seeking. As you go into your pyramid of light/power in the higher fifth dimension, through your intent, you can draw those light filaments to you in order to create that which you desire for the greatest good of all. We are opening the pathway for you to find your way back into our midst so that you can interact with us and integrate the wisdom, attributes and plasma of life that you will need to incorporate into your multidimensional vessel as you move deeper and deeper into the space where spirit dwells. When in your pyramid of light, ask that your council join you there. Ask them to assist you in your endeavors, to strengthen your resolve, and to give you the power, will and wisdom that you need to move into the next level of spiritual awareness. You all are in a critical phase of your spiritual growth process, whereby you are being asked to release all that is holding you back from the spiritual freedom you are seeking. This means outmoded beliefs, dysfunctional and restrictive relationships, harmful addictive and negative habits and thought patterns, and possessions that are taking up too much of your time, effort, and abundance. If you can view all that is presently in your life as transitory except the love/light and spiritual fire within your heart/soul, then you will know what we are trying to convey to you. Release your fear of the past and future, eliminate the emotional and mental controls others have on you and become the free spirit you were meant to be. We are ever near to assist and inspire you. You are loved profoundly. I am Archangel Michael.